Welcome back to Football Friday. You can see tonight's shout-outs at the bottom of your screen. One of tonight's first-round district AAA games matched up a pair of division rivals, Mid-Penn Keystone neighbors Hershey and Susquehanna Township. Indians won the regular season meeting, and they were leading 13-7 to start the third quarter when Lauren Butler gets the call in the handoff, and watch this run. Keeping the legs moving, never quits, finally breaks free, 24-yard touchdown. Hannah leads 19-7. Now we go to the fourth quarter, and it's Ben Moser. Nice play action. Guns it over the middle to Tavon Thompson. That's a 25-yard touchdown, and the Indians can smell the next round. Hershey trying to make a late run, but the pass picked off by Thompson. He's everywhere. Takes it back upfield. Finally gets knocked out of bounds in Hershey territory. And the Indians go to the Wildcat formation. Jordan Milbury on the snap takes it in. And Susquehanna Township moves on to the quarterfinals with a 33-15 win. Now let's head back to Mannheim now, where the Barons are celebrating a first-round victory with Barbara Barr.
We're back at Mannheim Central High School in the cafeteria where they're honoring their teams dating back to 1947. Behind me, members of the 2003 state championship game team, and you are Mike Byrne. And talk about this whole ceremony and seeing all the guys from all the years that play Baron football.
It was great. Honestly, you know, we never get together and see each other, at least beyond my group of friends, all the classes that came before us, and all the guys that, you know, paved the path for where Mannheim football is today.
What does it mean to have played for Mannheim Central?
It's a great honor. You know, like Coach was talking earlier, it's we played hard, we were coached hard, and we responded to that. It was just kind of, it's a pride thing. You know, we did it a certain way, and we did it the right way, and you know, it's a way of doing things, I guess.
Yeah. Congratulations. We've got some more highlights, AAA and Quad A games coming up. Co-Calico hosting Gettysburg, and the Eagles had the ground game working early. That's Matt Weinhold virtually untouched into the end zone. Point after no good. It's 6-0 Eagles at that point in the first quarter. And then Jet Janis, one of the top players in the league. He can't be stopped. 32 yards. He breaks away for the touchdown. Great all-around athlete, and the Eagles are really rolling at this point. And then one more time, Brad Whitaker with the 5-yard TD run, and Co-Calico big over Gettysburg, 43-8. Quad A game in Shillington. It was Central Dauphinese visiting Governor Mifflin at the half when Jan Johnson of the Mustangs hits Romello Martin 25 yards for the score, 20-13 Mustangs. But then Jordan Hatcher answers for the Panthers. He goes in from 16 yards out. They miss the extra point, so it's 20-19 Governor Mifflin. CDs would get the ball at their 1-yard line with a couple of minutes to go and put together a drive. Vinit Patel keeps the ball in the scramble here, goes out of bounds, and that's going to set up a Nate Dickey 34-yard field goal with 30 seconds to go. It's good. CD East leads by 22-20. Mifflin with one final shot. Do they get it? It falls incomplete. CD East gets its first ever District 3 playoff win, beating Governor Mifflin 22-20. All right, Pat, a couple of great games, and we'll be back here at Mannheim Central to wrap things up a little later in the show. We'll send it back to you.
Thank you, Barbara. Our second great finish of the night. Wilson is the number one team in our Grade A poll, and the unbeaten Bulldogs top seeded in the Quad A district bracket. Tonight they open the postseason with LL Section 1 rival Mannheim Township. The Blue Streaks gave the Dogs a pretty good battle the first time they met. Tonight, though, a different story. Wilson gives it to John Rafe Snyder, who races through traffic. Rush hour's got nothing on this guy. 27-yard touchdown puts Wilson on the board. Wilson gets it back, and hey, why not go to Rafe Snyder again? This time he goes in from the 16, and it's 14-0 Dogs. Wilson quarterback Matt Timochenko out with an illness, but his backup Jake Templin picks up the slack. A laser to Bryce Pitch. That same combo will work again moments later for another Wilson touchdown, and Wilson goes to 11-0 with a 44-6 romp. Mike Straub still trying to catch his breath after that Penn Manor Cedar Cliff barn burner. We go back to him now at West Shore Stadium.
Thank you, Pat, back at Cedar Cliff, and a big thanks to the Penn Manor Band doing their thing, making the trip on a cold night. It's tough to be in the marching band. Let's take a trip just across the way over in Mechanicsburg, Cumberland Valley, the number 2 seed, getting everything they could handle early on from the Harrisburg Cougars. Cougar band knows how to get it done. Early on, third and long for Harrisburg. Darius Davis Ray takes the handoff, shakes a man, shakes some more. First down and more. Keeps the drive alive. He's fired up. Leads to this, Michael Clark. Going in for the score, 6-0. Harrisburg takes the lead, but CB just doing what they do. Tyler Heisey on the goal line, touchdown. 7-6, Eagles go in front. Cougars take it to the air. Clark to Daquan Waters in traffic, goes up and gets it down to the half-yard line. Would lead to another touchdown, 13-7, Cougars in front. But in the second, CB has it, do what they do. Heisey on the goal line. This battle ends Cumberland Valley 27-23 over the Cougars. The Comet Band wrapping things up. Cumberland Valley, this time of year, they just know how to win. Keep right on rolling into the next round of the playoffs. We keep Football Friday rolling and go back to Pat Principe, our fearless leader, the mothership.
Thank you, Mike. Still ahead on our Football Friday playoff edition. Bishop McDevitt turns out the lights on its opponent, literally.